Let's take you back a little bit to the story of the closure of Gulu College of Health Sciences that we did suffer a glitch. Now what we know right now is that the Acholi parliamentary group has made an impassioned plea to the Ministry of Education to have the institution opened. That is a week after the students clashed with the police as they protested what they said were high tuition fees and mismanagement on the part of some of the administrators. But the latest communication from the Minister of Education indicates it will remain closed at least until investigations are complete.
Following last week's running battles between the police and the students at Gulu College of Health Sciences that led to the closure of the institution, the Acholi parliamentary group have weighed in on the matter.
Medical schools, they have started opening them. It is a pleasure for almost all Ugandans to see that the schools will be running time and again. Again to hear that a school which it is in the headquarters of Acholi sub-region is being closed, it gives us a lot of shame.
The legislatures Gilbert Olanya of Clark South, Simon Wokrach of Achua County, and former leader of opposition Betty Aolo Chan were led by their secretary, Okot John Amos, as they sought for a solution to the standoff between the students and the school administration.
Problem, Madam Principal, this is a very simple thing. You call the students' leaders, you sit down, you listen to them, and you iron it there. It should not warrant you to call for police tear gas to close the school. I think this is just wasting of time. If the ministry is directing that let the students pay top up of school fees of about 200,000 to buy sanitizers, face masks and other things, it is you to guide the ministry.
December 2021, because the students had refused to go to class. And the only reason this college exists is for students to go to class and learn and then go to the practical area and become health workers. So the fact that they were not going to class was not right. So their grievances to me were like they didn't want certain tutors, certain staff in the school. They also did not want the fee structure.
However, the students have come out again to complain that they are being forced to leave the school premises.
Things with the Acholi parliamentary group who helped us talk to the principal to reopen the school, and that was successful. As I speak right now, the place is ablaze. The RPC has ordered the DPC and the commissioner to come at school and chase students out of their hostels. As I speak right now, the students are out of the school premises. They're just standing outside the fences, waiting for the next move.
The former leader of opposition, Betty Aolo Chan, calls on the Minister of Education and Sports to act fast.
Prayer is also that you be peaceful. Because in case of any violence, then it is us to blame. But I want to say, let you be alert all the time. Because they destroy, is it a windscreen of a certain car? And they were blaming you, but I told the minister that no, honorable minister, do your ground work very well.
The issue has attracted the attention of Ministry of Education and Sports, who through Commissioner Dr. Safina Chisu Musene reiterated that the school remains closed.
I have come to inform the general public that the College of Health Sciences Gulu is closed. The date for reopening will be communicated to you by Minister of Education. And that's what I want the public to appreciate for now.
The school has over 940 students, with the majority currently stranded in front of the school gate alongside their belongings. The Minister of Education in a press conference this afternoon communicated that the closure of the school is being investigated. I am Joseph Omagor reporting for the news in Gulu City.